Good evening. Welcome to the worship of God at First Baptist Church during this Advent season for this service of cantata and candles. Those of you who are veterans to this service might think of lessons, carols, and candlelight. We're replacing the lessons and carols part with the cantata this evening, and we will be doing lessons and carols next Sunday morning on Christmas Eve instead of tonight. But tonight, the choir has worked very hard since I think 2008 to prepare this cantata for you. I want you to know that you're going to need this order of worship. In this order of worship, you will notice if you thumb through it that this cantata is participatory for you. Now, that's not to say you have to get up and dance or do rounds or anything, but there are parts of the cantata that are in bold in your order of worship, and Christy will turn around and lead you with the choir behind her when those parts come. You just watch the conductor, and when she turns around, you will join in. But if you follow along in this order of worship, you will find that. Also, if you don't have one of these, you need one of these. And the guy back there in the camo, sitting back there on the end, he'll get you one if you just raise your hand. Does everybody have one of these? Great. Good job, Doodlehead. That's his name. I'm not making fun of him. Good job. We will need these at the end because this service always ends with Silent Night, and it always ends with the passing of the light among the pews, and our processional out the front steps down to the live nativity where we will carol around the live nativity. This year it is the 46th annual live nativity. Come back in 4 years and it's a big deal. 50 years. All right. Well, so glad you're here. Let's pray before we lean in. All-loving God, we are grateful for this night of music and light in this sacred space. Be with us and guide us from here all the way out to the street to the live nativity that reminds us of a manger stuffed full of hope. This Advent and Christmas season. This we pray in Christ's name. Amen.
Thank you.
Before the choir takes over and offers the sermon and song this evening, I invite you to look in your order of worship to the Advent Litany that is printed there and join your voice with mine as we lean in on this December night. Your part is in the bowl. Advent is a holy season of expectant waiting and preparation for the birth of Christ.
It is also the journey from darkness to light.
The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light.
Those who dwell in the land of darkness, upon them light.
Advent is a holy season. We lean into the songs of the season that ignite within our weary souls.
The light of hope.
The light of peace.
The light of joy.
And the radiant light of love.
Emmanuel, God with us.
Amen.
Amen. In gratitude for the prophets and for all who bring the message of hope to our world, we light this candle of hope. How beautiful are the feet of those who bring the good news of the gospel, who preach glad tidings.
And today's messengers who proclaim the hope of salvation to people everywhere, we give thanks.
Born to sin, I
angel of the Lord appeared to shepherds, saying, "Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord." Suddenly, the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to all on whom his favor rests."
The announcement of his birth was not to royalty. I'm sorry, that's the wrong part. In gratitude for the shepherds who were the first to see the Prince of Peace, we light this candle of peace. The announcement of his birth was not to royalty or to the famous, but to the simple, common people of today. As they had seen him lying in the manger, the shepherds told everyone they met about this child, the bearer of peace. Hear the word of the Lord. Let us therefore make every effort to do what leads to peace, for there is a future for the people of peace.
And for today's ordinary people across the globe who welcome peace and work on its behalf, we give thanks. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem, Magi from the east came seeking him and asked, Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star in the east and have come to worship him. And the star they had seen went ahead of them and stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, the Magi were filled with joy.
In gratitude for wise men and seekers everywhere in search of Christ, we light this candle of joy. Hear the word of the Lord. I will turn your mourning into gladness. I will give you comfort and joy instead of sorrow. I will tell you the truth. You may weep and mourn while the world rejoices. You may grieve, but your grief will turn to joy.
For the Magi of yesterday who crossed the expanse of nations, and for those today who bridge chasms of the heart, earnestly seeking the source of everlasting joy, we give thanks.
Born is a child in manger's fold.
This is how God showed his love among us. He sent his one and only Son into the world that we might live through him. The Son of the Most High was born in humble surroundings of a stable because there was no room in the inn.
In gratitude for the one who found room in his stable and for all who have room in their hearts for the Savior, we light this candle of love. Hear the word of the Lord. I have loved you with an everlasting love. My command is this: love the Lord your God with all your heart, and love your neighbor as yourself.
For the one who opened the stable doors of yesterday, and for those who open their hearts today to the love of God, we give thanks.
Thank you.
gratitude for the one announced by the light of the stars and angels, we light the Christ candle. Hear the word of the Lord. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. On those living in the land of the shadow of death, a light has dawned. For the light of the Christ that shines in the darkness for all the people in all times, we give thanks.
Go now and share the good news of the gospel of peace. I have come to comfort those who mourn, to give them joy instead of sorrow, hope instead of despair. My unfailing love will not be shaken. My promise of peace stands forever. I have come into the world as a light, so that no one who believes in me should stay in darkness.
For God, who said, "Let light shine out of the darkness," has made his light shine in your hearts. No one lights a lamp and hides it. Instead, he puts it on a stand so that those who enter may see the light. In the same way, let your light shine. You're the light of the world. Go now as children of the light.
Thank you.
Christy is mouthing to me from the first pew, sorry. It's not that it was bad. It's that we're about 25 or 30 minutes early for the lighting of the live nativity. You think I can make something up that long? Are they ready? Well, good. Well, I'm going to... How about them out there? That's what all that yelling was about in the middle of the service that made me lose my place, right? I do, before I give a benediction, before we pass the light through the room, I do want to read the story of Jesus' birth from the Gospel according to Matthew. The Gospel according to Matthew is the one with the Magi in it, but it's not usually the one we read. We usually read Luke and the shepherds. So tonight, because we'll probably use Luke on Christmas Eve, I'm going to read to you the Gospel of Matthew as a kind of closing benediction to this wonderful sermon preached by this wonderful choir. Now the birth of Jesus the Messiah took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been engaged to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found to be pregnant from the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a righteous man and unwilling to expose her to public disgrace, planned to divorce her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophets. "Look, a virgin shall become pregnant and give birth to a son, and they shall call him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. When Joseph awoke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took her as his wife, but he had no marital relations with her until she had given birth to a son, and he named him Jesus. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born king of the Jews? For we have observed his star in the east and come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means the least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.' Then Herod secretly called the Magi and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, 'Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me a word so that I may go and pay homage to.' When they heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen in the east until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chest, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let's pray together. God, for this wonderful evening of music and scripture and the live nativity out front waiting for us, we are so grateful to you and grateful to all of those who have made it happen. God, be with us here, be with us out there, and be with us out in the world where we live our daily lives. Go with us, Emmanuel, God with us, each and every place we go. In Christ's name we pray it. Amen. Well, if you will take your candle out, and if you will stand and get ready to pass it among the friends around you. And as we do this, we're going to sing Silent Night. It's just the verse you know, over and over again, until we get outside to the nativity. It's as easy as that.